Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create an invisible camouflage effect and how you can apply it to a variety of backgrounds. Find an open background you'd like to use, as well as a subject you'd like to place onto it. Your subject can be color or black and white. I downloaded both of these images from Shutterstock. The first step is to make a selection around your subject so we can separate it from its background. There are many ways to do this, and your choice should depend on the characteristics of your photo. For this image, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, I find that the radius of 5 to 10 pixels works the best for most resolutions. The resolution for both of my images is 150 pixels per inch. You can check yours by going to Image and Image Size. Drag your tool either over the outside or inside of your image. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To check your selection, press Q to open your Quick Mask. To revert it back into a selection, press Q again. If you dragged your Quick Selection tool over the outside of your subject, we need to invert the selection. To do this, press Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Cut and copy the subject onto its own layer by pressing Ctrl or Command-J. Remove your subject's color by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-U. To place it onto your background document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of your background. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the background and release. To resize and reposition it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If your subject is too large to see all of it, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the Transform and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, we'll make your subject into a displacement map, which will be used to wrap your background around the contours of your subject. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of your Layers panel and click Duplicate Layer. Open the flyout list, click New, and type in Displacement. Then click OK. Since displacement maps have better results when they're slightly blurred, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 1 to 3 pixels and click OK. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop as a Photoshop PSD file and click Save. Then, close the displacement file. Click the eyeball next to your subject to hide the layer. Make your background active and make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. I'll make the horizontal and vertical scales between 20 to 30 pixels. However, keep in mind, you may want to use different amounts for all the effects I'll be using in this tutorial, depending on the size and resolution of your document. Tick Stretch to Fit and Wrap Around. Then, click OK. Click the Displacement PSD file that you saved earlier and click Open. Immediately, our background moved up and to the left as it took on the contours of our subject. We'll get rid of the aberrations on the bottom and right edges of our image in a few minutes. Make your subject visible and active, and change its blend mode to soft light. Change its fill to 50%. The fill reduces your subject's opacity, but it'll retain the full opacity of any effects that we'll be adding to it. Double-click your subject to open its layer styles. Click Inner Glow and change its blend mode to Color Dodge. Change the opacity to 20% and drag the choke and the size all the way to the right. Then click OK. Make a copy of your subject and double-click Inner Glow on the copy to see it in the Layer Style window. Change its blend mode to Soft Light. Drag its opacity all the way to the right and drag the choke all the way to the left. I'll make the size 20 pixels, but again, you may want to use a different amount. Make a copy of the layer and hide the effects of this copy. Change the blend mode to hard light and reduce its fill to 30%. Now that we can see our camouflaged subject over our background, we're ready to fill in the aberrations on the bottom and right edges. Scroll to the bottom and make your background copy active. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Open your brush tool and brush picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. Make the hardness 0% and make sure the opacity and flow are 100%. Then press enter or return. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. To make your brush bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush the areas on the bottom to reveal the original background and make sure you don't brush over your subject. Continue to brush over the right side as well. To replace the background with a different one, open the new background, press V to open your Move tool, and drag it onto the tab of your camouflage document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto your image and release. Make a copy of the new background and press Ctrl or Command F to repeat the last filter you applied, which was Displace. To fill in the aberrations on the bottom and right edges, scroll to the layer mask and press Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to the copy of the new background. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.